So we know a lot of you loved our masking transition tutorial. Well, in this video, we're going to show you a cool way of doing those kind of transitions without any masking at all. So let's get onto the streets. Right, let's go. So we've come outside to show you something you can do which is probably a lot more easier than the masking transition we showed you before, because actually a masking transition in Final Cut or Premiere can take a lot of time, and in many cases you can achieve the same results that you would have seen in our previous video up here. So we've come outside, and the first set of transitions we're going to show you, which you can do just using your camera, are called the whip pan transitions. Okay, so the first one is the whip pan transition. Now this one was made famous by people like Edgar Wright, and it's really, you know, really, really simple to do. All you have to do is essentially keep your focus and then whip sharply to the right or the left. But the real important thing here is you want to make sure that when you transition into your next shot, that you're also whip panning, starting in the same direction. So if you finish a shot and go from left to right, you want to start your next one going from left to right too, so they match up perfectly. It won't work if you get it the other way around. So that's the cool thing about a whip pan transition. You don't just have to go left to right, you can also go top to bottom or bottom to top too. And the next thing we do a lot of the time, which is really easy to use, is use an object. And this makes it much more like the masking transition we showed you in the previous tutorial. So you can use a pole, a car, a vehicle, a tree, anything, but we'll show you that now. So panning behind an object is a really, really easy transition to do, and I think the effect is really cool. It really transports your viewer to somewhere new. So next we're going to show you how you can sort of transition using colors as well. So solid colors are also cool to transition into. So you can transition into this and then back out of a red sign like that, and it creates a cool transition like this. Okay, so let's jump into Adobe Premiere Pro, and I'll show you how you can make these transitions work for you using this footage. So the first transition we showed was the whip pan transition. So making this transition work is, you know, really actually very simple. All you have to do is simply put the two clips together that you filmed, and then what you want to do is get your first clip and then just end this during the motion blur whip pan that you've done. And then you want to grab your second clip and then get that second clip to start during the beginning of the whip pan motion that you did, where it's all nice and blurry. So all you need to do then, once you've got them both on your timeline, is simply join together these two cuts, and timed right, you'll have the perfect transition. It's really as simple as that. So another little tip to make sure you perfect this is to make sure that you've got your camera settings dialed in. A lot of people will always use automatic focus, you know, it's getting better and better. But for a transition like this, you really want to switch over to manual focus and then move your shot to where you want to end, get the manual focus dialed in, and then start your shot. And do this for obviously the shot you're leaving and the shot you're going into. And this just means that your subject will be perfectly in focus when you do that whip pan. The last thing you want is the focus to be kind of hunting as it reaches the subject. And you know, you get that kind of in and out of focus effect. You don't want that. So always use manual focus. So another little tip is to make sure you use some sound effects. So you can see here in Premiere, we've got our two shots, but we've added some sound effects below them. And a well-placed sound effect can really trick the viewer to thinking they're watching the same sequence of shots. You know, if you've got a shot and the sound suddenly jumps, then it's gonna really take your viewer out of the experience. So you wanna make sure you've got some sound effect beds that just go between the shots. And here you can see we've used some whooshes, and we've also used some ambient street sound effects to take, you know, the viewer on the journey. Now, if you need any sound effects, I'll put a link in the description to where we get all of ours. Now, the second transition is just as easy to do. So this is the transition using the objects. And all you need to do is really follow the first steps in the first example. So what you want to do is cut during the motion, just as the object takes over the full frame of the shot. Now, don't worry if it's too slow. You can always add a little bit of speed ramping. And again, just make sure you have your camera set on manual focus for this one. Now, you can get really creative with this one. And the great thing about this second transition is that you can use almost any object that you want. Just remember though that you have to have the same movement as in the previous transition, and you also want the object to completely fill the frame. So for example, this bag backpack shot is very, very similar to our really popular masking transition we did in Adobe Premiere Pro, where we showed you how to mask. But a lot of people thought that was quite time consuming and a little bit complex. And to be honest, it is if you're a beginner. So you can almost get the same masking transition effect without doing any masking at all. So in this case, instead of doing the lengthy masking, just make sure you fill the screen with the black backpack or a similar color if you're using something else, and then start your second shot coming out of something similar to the object, or and just make sure it looks like the previous shot. And again, make sure you're going in the right direction and you'll get a transition just like this. Now for the third one, we're using colors, and colors are a great way of creating a really unique and creative transition. So for this one, you have to be careful as you want to make sure you match the same kind of colors and shades within the color too. So if it's not quite right, then you'll have to do a little bit of work in post. And you can see that's what we've done here in Premiere. Now this one here is a really good one because you can get really creative with what you're transitioning to and from. And to do this, you know, it's just the same process as before. Just put the two clips together and then hide the cut using the colors, and then just find a frame that matches the next color as close as possible. Now, in some cases, the colors aren't gonna match exactly. So to help make this technique smoother in this shot, you can see we've also added a little tiny cross dissolve effect. You know, that's what we've done here. And I think you'll agree, it just helps blend the two reds together absolutely perfectly. So there you go, what do you think of those three transition ideas? I really like these because it gives you a very similar look to the masking transitions that we taught you before, but it's just a lot easier and simpler to do as long as you plan that shot. But what I like is you get something that A, looks really, really creative, but B, you can do this kind of shot on your iPhone. So if you're creating an Instagram story, you could use your iPhone to film, you know, get one shot, do the whip pan transition, do the cuts, edit it in something like LumaFusion or Premiere Rush or even iMovie, and then you can use these on your social media. So they're great for quick run and gun videos, but they're also great to add in sequences like you've seen in this video. But anyway, if you've got any questions, let me know. Put a comment below, as I promise we do get back to every single one. And if you want to learn more about the actual masking transitions that we've done before, you can see that by clicking up here or checking out our other playlists. But anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.